Hello everyone, welcome to ISF Asset Presents Be and Beyond, a talk show which takes us through the journeys of alpha geeks from around the world, wherein they share with us their experiences and expertise in the top tier fields of technology and science. This is Om Shetty, your host for the episode. Today, we have with us Mr. Naveen Sridhar. He's an A320 rated commercial pilot and a web developer. Apart from this, he's the founder of a website design and development company called WebStart 360. And also, he has co-founded a sports apparel and accessories business called Neva Sports. Hello, sir. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you. It's a pleasure to join you here. Thank you.
I have been going through your profile and I'm super excited to talk to you. Same. So, my first question to you is, you have been very active since your college itself. So, could you share your experience as a student in WSET and how it prepared you for the community out there?
So the entire experience at WSET was really amazing because I selected instrumentation engineering because it is so much related to aviation, and the labs that we had in WSET was so nice, and it was something which gave us the practical experience that one would require when they went for a field job. But I had made up my mind that since I was so much interested in aviation and website development, I would do something related to either one of those. So towards the end of the course, in the third year and towards the start of the fourth year, I was looking at job vacancies in instrumentation as well, but I was more interested in the IT sector. So I had filled a form in which it said that I will not be going for my further studies in the US. So I was clear on that. But so the instrumentation department gave me an opportunity to connect with the IT world because we had such amazing professors. I would like to name one, Mr. Gopal Krishnan. He introduced us to IT so very well that my interest for the subject increased tenfold. And yes, it was a really good experience being at WSET overall.
Yeah. So the next question is, you wanted to become a pilot, but you chose to pursue engineering and instrumentation instead of directly opting for a conventional pilot training program. So what was your thought process behind this?
So directly after 12th, I was going to go for this conventional pilot training, which is simply a certificate course. So it was very risky at that time because job openings weren't as many and no one guarantees you a job. So it was a good decision on my part that I went for the graduation before going for pilot training. And it was my parents who suggested to go for this course before directly going for the pilot training. So, and yes, as I already said, instrumentation is so much related to aviation. I had made up my mind that if I am going to do engineering, then it's going to be in this field.
I guess the engineering experience also helps when you become a pilot. Like the technical,
A lot. And overall, any four-year degree course makes you more mature and it helps you tackle with real-life situations and working under pressure, working under deadlines, and dealing with people like your professors, your batchmates, and it makes you more mature overall. So yes, I think it was a really good decision, and anyone else who's also going for this path should definitely go for graduation first, because that gives you an upper hand over the other candidates, and also it is good to have a graduation certificate, generally speaking.
Yes, people often say that like a four-year engineering degree, it teaches a lot about you as a yourself, and then you learn a lot, and then people often maybe they try, they pursue their engineering degree for the master's, or maybe they continue in any other field.
Correct. It helps you a lot.
So my third question to you is, how can one enroll into a pilot training program after completing his bachelor's in engineering? Could you elaborate on your experiences during your training and the challenges that you faced during it?
Sure. So after your bachelor's, you can either opt for what is called a cadet pilot program, which I opted for, or you can go directly and join some flying training institute in India or abroad and continue with your training over there. So your flight training basically consists of clearing some theory papers and also clearing your medical exams, which is really important. Because if you are not medically fit, it might be something very simple or silly. But if you don't clear those standards of medical fitness, you will not be allowed to fly. And then your entire money will go to waste. So clearing your medicals, clearing your theory papers, and then you can go ahead with your flying hours, which is the actual fun part of flying 200 flying hours. And that is what you always dreamed for. And that is a really fun experience. So I had gone for the Jet Airways Cadet Pilot Program. It consisted of a really long process, which consisted of the selection process, having an interview and something which they call a personality questionnaire. Then there was many such small selection processes. And then finally, when I got selected, my course asked me to go to US. So my training was done in the US in Phoenix, Arizona. And since it was such a new place, and of course, everyone likes to go to the US, but then it's an entirely different experience because it is not what you see in the movies. The place looks like what you see in the movies, but then you have to start being independent. You have to do your own laundry. You have to make your own food. So initially, when we went there, we took a lot of ready-to-eat stuff. And we just heated that in the microwave and then had it. But then later on, we knew that this is not a long-term sustainable solution. So we started cooking, and then that's how that worked out really well, you know. And now I know to cook so well that people say, "Are wa, you know to cook so well. How did you learn all this?" So YouTube was a really good partner at that time, because everything, right from laundry to how to press your own shirts or to cook food, or everything we learned from YouTube. And so we were like four people staying in a room. And so again, that part also brought about the sense of teamwork and I would say coordination. And yes, I mean, I would say that my entire experience in the US, I was there only for 9 months. It is a really short course because you have to fly only 200 hours. So it doesn't take that long. But and the weather over there is really good. In India, if you continue with your pilot training, weather is a big issue because of the monsoon. So you're not allowed to fly in monsoon because it is a small training aircraft. So all this training happens in a four-seater aircraft, which is very small. And once you have that license, you cannot fly commercially anywhere. I mean, you can fly, but then you will have to join the private airlines or something like that. So right now I have an A320 rating, which allows me to fly the Airbus A320. So currently waiting for job opportunities in the piloting sector. But till then I have started these two startups of mine, which I hope to sustain in the future.
Yes. So moving on to the fourth question, that is, people often have this misconception that entering into the aviation field is basically means to become a pilot. So can you give our viewers an insight into the different job roles in the aviation industry?
Yes, definitely. So one of the very important roles in the aviation industry is definitely the pilot. But people who are on the ground also contribute a lot towards the safe operation of the flights. So after your engineering degree, a very important role that you can opt for in the aviation field is a skipper. So a skipper is the person who looks after all the technicalities of the flight. He verifies everything, like where the cargo is loaded or how many passengers need to be seated at what position in the aircraft, or where the food in the aircraft is going to be stored, in the front or at the back, and how much fuel needs to be carried. Then they also need to check the weather en route the flight, and also at the departure and the destination. So these are all things that you learn on the job and also during your training. But it gives you a very, I mean, it gives you an upper hand if you have an engineering degree. So a lot of people who just go after their 12th course, they usually go for this flight dispatcher job, which is not that highly paying, but it is also a fun job. But speaking about engineering graduates, skipper is a really good opportunity. And basically, so anything which is related to the technical portion of the flight.
So basically, each and every person is important, so as to ensure that like the whole process, that is the journey from flying from one airport to the another, goes well.
Yes. And actually, one more thing, when I had gone for my interview for the Jet Airways Cadet Pilot Program, I met this one person who had an engineering degree. And he had gone to, I don't remember which country, but he had gone somewhere, and then he did his cabin crew training. So he was a steward, a cabin crew, and he worked as a cabin crew for many years at Jet Airways. And then now he is, he has finished his pilot training, and now he is going for becoming a pilot. So you should do what you like. You have to explore different professions in the field and then see what suits you best. And then work accordingly towards it.
Yeah, certainly. I suppose exploring any field, like for the matter of fact, is quite important because you understand whether or not that particular field is good or yeah.
Absolutely.
So one of the highlights of your career is your startup in web development. What was your inspiration behind getting into the field of web development?
So about a decade ago, when I was in my 11th or my 12th standard, we had this subject called IT. And it was a really generalized topic called IT. And they taught us to build websites in that. And I thought, is it that easy to build websites? Of course, it was not the flashy websites that we get these days, or the very modern looking websites. But then it allowed me to explore more into this field. And then I did a lot of research. And someone had told me at that time that you can put ads on your website and earn money on the basis of that. So I was really interested in that. So the first website that I ever made was my mom's cookery channel. So she used to post recipes and videos on that. And then I used to put ads on the side. So I got some $100 or $150. And then I was really happy. I gave some money to my mom, and then I kept the rest for myself. Then very soon after that, there was this uncle of mine who is an astrologer. So he also wanted a website. So I thought, okay, I've got some fair bit of experience, but I'm still a beginner. If you're okay with it, then I can go ahead and make a website for you. So that was the starting point of this thing that I started, the website development thing. And then when I appeared for placements at Visit, at that time also, when I got to know that Wisdom Labs, a software development company, was coming in for recruitment, I was really interested in that because they were into website design and development and into the WordPress side. So WordPress is a content management system, which most of the, I think almost 70% of the websites is using WordPress these days. And I also had a friend over there working. So he told me, he gave me some insight into the company, saying what this company is doing and what is their actual requirement. So that helped a lot. And I was really interested in that, but maybe not at that time. So I never joined the company, but I went through the selection process and got selected. I think only two or three web developers were selected from the entire college. So most of the other people were into business development, but as web developers, only two or three, I think. So that was a really happy moment for me, and I was really proud of myself. But then I thought, if I stayed in this field, then maybe I would not be able to pursue my passion in aviation. So, and instead of wasting the company's time and efforts, I thought that maybe in the future, if I want to join, then I might join. But maybe, I mean, that is not that was not my future goals. So I told them that it doesn't align with my future goals. So I would like to not join the company. So I immediately went for the pilot training course.
So like, while worrying about job security, most people stop chasing their dreams. But in your case, you chose to turn down the job offer that you had. and to follow your passion in aviation. So what would you say about that?
So I would say that if you like something from your heart, if you want to do it, and if you want to wake up in the morning and if you are really motivated and excited to do it, then you have to go ahead and pursue that dream or goal of yours. But if it is something which you consider as a 9-to-5 job or something which is a work from home and it's a headache for you, then no, you should not do it. I know people want to earn money these days. So if just survival is your main motive, then I'm sorry, that is not the way to live. If you want to follow your passion and your dreams, then you have to do something out of the box. You have to think out of the box and do something big. So even when I had, I had got into the Jet Airways Cadet Pilot Program, right? And in April 2019, the company itself got closed down. So I didn't take that as a negative point. In fact, I went ahead with my training, got my other licenses. And so even after that, when the COVID lockdown happened, it was never a negative thing for me. I explored many more opportunities. I started this own startups of mine, of the website development company and the sports apparel sales business, and took that as a challenge instead of taking that as a negative point. So if you like to do something, or if you have a dream in mind, if you want to do something for the society, then you should go ahead and chase that dream instead of just opting for a regular 9-to-5 job. If that gives you happiness, if that 9-to-5 job is also giving you happiness, then it is good. Go ahead and pursue that. Maybe you will become a big boss one day, and then you will look back and see and say that, yes, it was the right decision. So it depends on what you feel and what you like to do, what you would like to do in life.
Yes, it's quite inspiring to hear from you. And then it's like often said that you should chase your dreams, and like money will follow, like when you work hard and then exactly. You chase your dreams. Yeah.
Ask and you shall receive. That's how the world works.
Yes. So as you said, you are the founder of Webstart 360 and co-founder of Neva Sports. Tell us more about them and how do you manage both the startups at the same time?
It is definitely a task. It is a big task because I started off initially as advertising on Instagram. I was new to Instagram at that time as well, about 6 months ago. And then so I got myself a website first for the business, and then getting new customers was a big task. So making new content on Instagram, making reels and advertising on WhatsApp. And advertising is a really big challenge when it comes to starting something new of your, something, a new business. Because if the world doesn't know about you, then they are not going to come to you. So advertising and getting customers is a big task. And then, yes, having two startups at the same time is really hectic. And because dealing with customers is a big task. And building websites is not something which is done in one day. So it usually takes around 1 week, but it can go long. I mean, one of my clients, I started work in July this year and then finished in September. So it took 3 months. Of course, 1 month she went to Kashmir. So, but it takes usually around 7 days, but it can go as long as 2 months. So in those 2 months, you have this Neva Sports also to do. You have to deal with other customers. You have to arrange Zoom meetings. You have to share sample templates with your client to understand what they want. And so some clients are very picky about what they want. And some days are very frustrating because they would say that, mujhe ye nahi chahiye, I don't like this, what are you showing me? And then it becomes really difficult to understand their requirements and to deliver. So of course, we have always delivered good quality websites and functional websites. But it becomes a great challenge when it comes to customer service and to manage advertising. So these are two really big things which are growing in the market as of now. So people are making careers in digital marketing as well. But I didn't hire any digital marketing person. I did everything on my own. And I am happy to see that it has grown to what it has grown today.
Yeah, you seem like a person who has a lot of skills. Like, you have pursued your career in like aviation industry. Then you are a web developer. Apart from that, you are a startup owner, and then you also pursue your hobby, that is cycling.
Cycling, yes.
Yes.
Even during my college days, I used to cycle to college on some days. And I used to do a lot of endurance cycling. I have cycled as long as 400 kilometers in 24 hours. So that is a lot.
And that's quite amazing.
I mean, you have to do everything that you like to do, and whatever is your passion, continue doing it.
Okay, so you spoke about customers and how customers are important. So be it either the startup or the aviation industry, they are both very customer centric.
Yes, definitely.
Yeah, so why is being customer centric important for any business?
So if you are able to deliver a product, but it doesn't meet the customer's satisfaction, then they are either going to get it from you and then never contact you again, or they are not going to take it from you only. So customer satisfaction is really important in any business. And understanding the customer's requirement is also a big thing. Because if they are expecting certain XYZ in their mind and you deliver something else, then that is not a very pleasant thing. So I am currently working with three other interns, and I hope to leave it to them to manage the entire business. And then I'll just get the customers and, you know, basically supervise their work. But customer interaction is really important. And I think I am not confident in hiring someone to deal with my customers as of now. Maybe in the future, I'll keep someone for that as well. But since the past 6-7 months, I have understood customers very well. And then I feel that it is definitely not an easy job. And yes, it is very much closely related to aviation as well. So I feel all this is going to work out very well. And then when I get a job as a pilot also, it is going to work very well.
Yeah, communication is very important, be it any field. Yeah. You need to be able to communicate with the other person and then make sure, even sometimes people don't understand the same language, but then still being able to communicate with the, with your hand and then conveying the information to him is a big thing.
Yes, absolutely.
Okay, so coming to the end of the interview, any valuable lessons that you would like to share with our viewers?
I think I already shared during the course of this interview, the very important thing being follow your dream always and work hard towards it. Actually, it need not be working hard always. Working smart is also very important. Even when it comes to engineering, how to do your assignments on time or how to get projects done, it is really important. How to work as a team in your BE project. So all this is very important. And when you do small things like documentation also, it gives you a really high sense of professionalism and how the customer is going to receive that as a product in the industry. So pay attention to detail. That is what one thing which I noticed in students that is lacking. So attention to detail and working smart and hard and study well also. Don't lack in studies, but be good in projects and, not get good marks. Just follow your dreams. And if you like that 9-to-5 job, then go for it. Maybe it is meant for you. But don't be misguided or don't go to some place just because someone else told you that the job is nice or the pay is good. Because if you're not going to enjoy it at the end of the day, then the payment is not going to bring about a positive change in you. I think these are my few points for students who are in their BE right now.
Yes, I'm sure they'll learn a lot from this interview. Thank you so much. It was such a pleasure talking to you. I'm sure our audiences have got inspired by your journey and experiences. For more such interviews, tune into our YouTube channel. See you in the next episode of BE and Beyond. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to our channel. Thank you. Bye-bye.